based on the experience, it's pretty clear to me that like you've done this before, and so therefore you know exactly what's required to meet reach the market. And so once you have that, so once you've aligned the game, right? So you're like, okay, cool, we need to penetrate at a mass scale.
Yep.
Is that when you started looking for athletes?
It was always clear to me that from an authenticity perspective, that they had to be part of our story, period. And, okay. and not just the marketing narrative, which is where I think a lot of brands get it wrong, which is like, let's put this person up on a poster or right. billboard. It was like, you know, if you go back to the origins of Adi Dassler, who founded Adidas, you know, and was on the track and field in 1932 or whatever mm-hmm. it was, giving, I think it was Jesse Owens, his first pair of running shoes because he couldn't find any or whatever mm-hmm. when he was there in Berlin. You know, that's a real story. This guy was a cobbler by trade, mm-hmm. making this for the athlete to help them run. You know, Phil Knight was doing the same thing up in Oregon,
right.
you know?
Right.
And that's, and we live in an era where so much is superficial and so much is faked now, right? Because you can just hyper accelerate and again, raise a ton of capital and put sure. celebrities behind it. And before you know it, you're kimono or whatever that Kardashian, you know, body spandex suit. Well, I think they changed the name now. It's not kimono anymore, but was kimono.
Sure.
But, you know, the point was, if you don't have authenticity and you don't have a mission and a North Star and those people, you know, opining on where your company should go, if you are genuinely serving the athlete, then there's no point in doing this. Otherwise, it's fake to mm-hmm. begin with, right? And our approach was always going to be, hey, we're going to hit these sports events and grassroots communities around the country because that is a gathering point for the athlete out on the field every day. That's one of the beautiful things about the business that I'm in is that there's a pre-existing community of networked people who are fervent and passionate. I wouldn't imagine myself getting anywhere near the same traction if I was going down Sunset banging my drum saying all natural, all botanical, sure. No one's going to give a shit.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
But if it's about, hey, I'm here to develop products with you to serve the athlete. Tell me your response and how it felt on your skin when you performed. How do you, you know, do you feel more confident? Is it lasting all day? Is it smelling good? Does it make you feel good? Then I can constantly come back to that community and refine and refine. And so it was, on the one hand, it was a case of saying, okay, what is authentic to this domain? Mm-hmm. And then on the other hand, it was, you know, in the case of Kobe had been building the Nike brand for 20-something years.
Sure.
And so, and he was also deeply involved in Body Armor. And he understood that really careful spot between sport and lifestyle. That's the magic spot. It's not, you know, if it's sport just for the sake of athleticism and just for the hardcore CrossFit junkie, that's a different brand.
Right.
But we have to transcend that. We have to be funny. We have to be interesting. We have to be different. We have to be relevant for the kid playing PS4 or playing Madden. Like
right.
that's important.
Right.
So
right,
how
right.
do you design a brand that speaks authentically to the athlete, develops for them, and is relevant then culturally across that? And so the athletes we brought on board are not just amazing athletes. They're amazing cultural voices mm-hmm. in their communities. And James Harden's another great example of that.
Hey, everyone. Thanks for checking out that clip. If you enjoyed it, be sure to hit the like button down below. And if you're interested in hearing the full episode, it's out right now on our YouTube channel. We've had a lot of great guests come on this show before, and we've got a lot of great guests coming up in the future. So hit subscribe so that you don't miss a single episode. And one final note, we're always looking for new ideas and new companies to feature on the show. So if you know of someone or know of a company, write us a comment down below letting us know who they are and what they do. We'd be happy to have them on the show. Till then, I'll just be here waiting for your comments. So, see you later.